Hey, this is Max here. In this tutorial, I want to show you how you can deliver a lead magnet inside ActiveCampaign. So first I'm going to talk a bit about what a lead magnet is, why you need one, and then I want to show you like the techie stuff of how you can create forms and automations. And before we're going to dive in, I quickly want to mention that I also put all the resources in the description box below. So like the automations, I also created a cool cheat sheet. You'll find that in the description box below. So let's dive right in. So first, let's start with what is a lead magnet. Now, a lead magnet is basically an incentive that we give in exchange for an email address. So think about like an ebook or a cheat sheet or a checklist or templates or white papers, reports, like can be anything basically. Now, why do you need a lead magnet? Like, yeah, why would you create one at all? Now, I think people, especially people who are probably don't know you so well, so most of your visitors, aren't simply going to give you their email address without a good reason. Like, people are not like browsing your website and they're like, hey, cool, there's like an opt-in box here. Let's just throw my email address into it and see what happens, right? That's not how it works. So I think as marketers, it's our job to give them a good reason for them to do so. So this is not a full tutorial about how to create the perfect lead magnet, but I wrote down some quick tips anyway. So I, for example, think a lead magnet should be quickly to digest. So usually I would not go for like a 200-page ebook, because then people receive the ebook and then they will put it aside for another time to read. And then that other time probably turns into never. And you really want people to basically take action now, like do something with your content, actually consume it. Now, then I think it should also give them like a quick win. So help them to easily achieve something. And it should also be of high value. So it should not just be perceived as valuable, but it should actually help someone by having something that's actually valuable. So you can create like an awesome opt-in page with like, hey, this is like the best checklist ever. And then they receive the checklist and like three bullets in it. And they're like, okay, this is actually not so valuable. You really do not want that. Now, then I think a lead magnet should also show your expertise. Like, you should show that you are an expert. So these are just some quick tips, but I'll make sure to create like another cool tutorial about how to create like the perfect lead magnet. Now, then I want to dive into the automation part, into ActiveCampaign. So first, we're going to create a form in ActiveCampaign that you can put on your website and then people can fill it out and then automation will start. But you can also create forms with tools like Opt-in Monster or Thrive Leads, or for example, myself, I'm a huge fan of Write Message. All these tools are just fine and they're basically doing a little bit of like, the same, right? So as long as you have like a cool form to like add people to your list, then it doesn't matter how you set that up. Now, then our automation is going to get a start trigger. So we're going to use a tag for that. Then we're going to deliver the download. Then we're going to resend an email with that download to people who do not open the first email. And then we're going to start our onboarding. So let's dive into ActiveCampaign and then I can show you how that works. So to create a new form in ActiveCampaign, you need to go to forms and then view forms. And then when you want to create a new form, you just click create a new form, you give it a name, you click inline form, and then you can already set what actions will happen. So I, for example, want to deliver my download ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. So that's actually this cheat sheet. It's actually a cool thing. I will also put this in the description box below in case you want it, but we want to deliver that. I will call it the second one because I already created one here. And then what we want to do is we want to subscribe someone to our main list. Like, as you can see, I have a main list and a customer list. I also created a separate tutorial about this. I will make sure to link to that in the iCard above. So we have our main list and then I want to add a tag. So what I want to do is I want to add a tag that says requested ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. So if you use another tool like Opt-in Monster or Write Message or Thrive Leads, you usually you can also do this. You can like tell them, okay, I want them, the people to subscribe to this list and I want to add this tag. So this is how I named my tag, like event requested and then the thing that they requested. Then I'm going to click create and then we wait till it's created. And then we can like change some things. So usually you already have like some text here and I really do not like that because I just want to do that on my website. So I will delete that in my case, but obviously you can do it differently if you want to. And then I'm also going to disable the branding because I also don't like that so much. So then we have like a really simple form. This I'll change to first name. I do not need to know people their full name. And then I will change this into your first name. And this I want to change into your email address. And then also the button I want to change to send me the cheat sheet. Something like this, right? And then you can go crazy with styling. You can give this button like a color, or you can add like an emoji. You can do like quite a lot of things with that. So this is what it looks like on my website after like I styled it with some more CSS. But as you see, it's like a very simple opt-in page. It says like, thanks for watching, join the list and receive the ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. And then you can enter your first name, your email address, and then you can click send. And here is another example with a different download that I have in the end of like a blog article. So here it says like, get the challenge automation. Let me send you the side challenge, blah, blah, blah. That we have built in this guide, first name, email address, send me the automation. So here you see how you can like style it into different things and then add it nicely to your website. So let's go back over to that. I will not go too deep into styling right now, but you have this form, then you click integrate, and then here you get a code that you can add to your website, and then you can maybe ask a developer, or you can look up some examples online of how you can style that form. Then we're going to click save and exit, and then you see that we have created this. So that's how we create our form. Now then we want to create our automation. So to start the automation, we want to trigger like that automation based on that requested tag, and then we want to deliver the download. So let's go over to automations. I already created a lead magnet delivery automation, that's how I called it. Let's wait. And then you see here how it works. So let me explain how it works. So we have the trigger in this event requested ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. As soon as that tag is added, this automation will start. And the first thing that I do is that I remove the tag. Like it just has served its purpose. Like the purpose of this tag was to start this automation, and then I just delete it right away. I also created a whole separate tutorial about tags if you like to watch that. Now then we send our email with the cheat sheet. Then we wait until someone has opened this email, or if they clicked a link inside this email. Because sometimes people like block that you can track if an email is opened, but link clicks will always work. So here we have a wait until, and this is the condition. We just wait until they opened it or if they clicked a link. And then we do that for up to 2 days. So that means someone who opens this email or clicks a link inside this email will like continue right away. And someone who doesn't will continue after 2 days. Then we have an if else. So an if else is to like split the automation, and we split it based on if someone opened the email or clicked a link inside the email. So if they did not open this email or not click a link inside this email, then we resend the same email with a different subject. So then we increase the chances of them like, yeah, opening the email at all. And then this is like a bit of a big block, but we wait until they basically opened the first email or the second email, or if they clicked the link in the first email or in the second email. And after that, they will continue, and then they get a tag that says event received ActiveCampaign cheat sheet. So I know that they basically already received it as soon as they get the email, but I just find it a good practice to actually tag them when you know that they opened that email or clicked a link inside the email, so that you really know, okay, they really received this basically. And then in the end of that automation, we check if they already have entered our onboarding. So I created like an onboarding automation. We'll show you that in a bit for new contacts. So if they're already in that, then we exit. If not, then we add them to that basically. So then I want to show you something cool inside our email, because I have added some conditional content. So imagine someone filled out a form on your website, right? Like for this cheat sheet, for example, And then you just not just want to say like, hey, here's your download, right? Like you basically want to give them like a warm welcome onto your list. You want to say like here, for example, hey, Max, thanks for joining the list. Glad you found me on this little corner of the internet. From now on, I will send you one valuable email every Tuesday. I think you will like it. Now I will do my best, blah, 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 blah. And then it says, here's the cheat sheet you asked for. So this little paragraph is like our welcome, right? It's like in this box, as you can see. And what this is conditional content. So we only show this to people who are new on our list. Now, how do we do that? Now, for that, I first need to show you a different automation. And again, all the automations that I'm creating right here and showing you, you can find in the description box below. So here is an automation that is called Tag New Subscribers. Contact subscribes to any list. That is the start trigger of our automation. So as soon as you subscribe to a list, this automation will start. They get a tag that says event, recent activity, joined list. And then after 15 minutes, we delete that tag again. So then we know that new contacts have this tag for 15 minutes. Now, and with this tag, we can create some conditional content. So with this box, you can see if you click this wheel and then manage conditions, you can see that this block will only show to people that have the tag equals event recent activity joined list. And that's the tag that we added here for 15 minutes. So only people who receive this email basically for the first time, they get like a warm welcome. And then if they download maybe a different lead magnet a week later, a day later, an hour later, doesn't matter, then they only get, hey Max, here's the cheat sheet you asked for, right? So I think that's like a really, really cool trick. So let's go back to the automation. We click save and exit. And then, yeah, as I said, we wait until they opened. Did they open? Then we continue and we go to our onboarding automation. If not, then we resend our email and then we wait until they open that one. And then it depends a bit like how what you're using this for, but either you just wait forever until they like open this and then it works as kind of like a double opt-in. Like if they do not open any of these emails, they will also not continue into your onboarding. But if you want, you can also set a time limit to that. You can also say, here, I want to wait for up to 1 week and then I want to continue to my onboarding. So the onboarding looks like this. I will show you that very briefly because that's also the subject of the new tutorial. Okay, let me show you. So here you see, this is the automation that people get added to. So they just get an email that says you're in case they did not receive anything yet, and then some more, a few other emails. But yeah, this was basically the tutorial about how you can deliver a lead magnet. So let's go over it briefly again. A lead magnet is an incentive to give an exchange for an email address. You need one because you need to give people a reason to like, yeah, give you your email address. Then we deliver them with creating a form inside ActiveCampaign, or you can create a form by using opt-in monster, drive leads, or write message. And then we have our automation with a start trigger. We deliver the download. We check after 2 days. Okay, did they open it or not? If not, we resend the email. And if they open the email, we give them a different tag about that they received it. And then we're going to start the onboarding. So yeah, that's also what our next tutorial is about. You see it here on screen now. And it is about how you can onboard new contacts inside ActiveCampaign. I think it's something that's really, really, really important. Something that you absolutely need. You do not want to send like a bunch of like random emails. So yeah, that was this tutorial. If you enjoyed it, give it a little thumbs up and be sure to subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.